Hi guys, and welcome back to the channel Cookies Gaming Universe. Yes, that's me, Coco, and today I am back in Adopt Me, and I will be telling you a few tips and tricks on how to get neons. So, I just recently started collecting neons. So right now I have a neon bee, a mega cat, and a neon otter. I also had a neon wolf, but I traded it. So I did have four. But today I will be giving you some tips on how to get neons. And after, I will give you a tour of my new and improved house. So let's get started. First tip is always have your pet that you're trying to make neon out. Right now I'm trying to make a neon monkey, so even when you're trading, I suggest to have your pet out so that way it'll get tasks to do and stuff. And that's tip number one. Tip number two. So if you want to make your pet go to bed or get closer to the school or whatever, what you want to do is you want to open up your inventory, and if you want to make your pet go to bed in the pet and baby's nursery, just press add where the pets are and it'll teleport you to the nursery. The main teleportation thing that I normally do is gifts. I press add and teleport to the gifts to get closer to the school, to the nursery, to the hospital, to wherever you want to go. So that was tip number two. Tip number three. If you want to get your pets to a higher level, I suggest to mostly stay in the school because it has food and it can also sleep and stuff, and you could feed it for free without having to waste any of your food. So that was tip number three. Tip number four. So if you have four pets of a legendary or four pets of a rare, four pets of a common, I suggest going from common to legendary because common pets take the least time. And I suggest doing the ones that take the least time and go up to the legendary. I actually don't have any legendary yet, but I am working on getting some legendary neons. So that was tip number four. Tip number five. So tip number five is always look at the invitations, the invitations to parties, because sometimes they say, grow up your pet here, because they have a lot of pet supplies, and it's just a smart way to grow up your pet fast, so I really suggest doing that. Tip number six. So this tip is before you actually get four pets. So the way I suggest to get four common or uncommon pets easily is to add up money and get cracked eggs. So I suggest trying to save $2,000 to get I don't know how many cracked eggs you can get. You could probably get six. So that's what I suggest doing, and open all of them to see if you have four. And if you still don't have four and you only get three or two pets, go into the trading area, which is right over there. There's an arrow pointing to it. But once you get over there, just say trading for whatever pet you need. And most likely, if it's a common, uncommon, or rare pet, most people will have it. Tip number seven. So over here, if you're wondering how to make neons, because if you're new, you probably don't know how to, what you want to do is you want to go over here in the water, and you want to go into this little secret type door thingy-majiggy, I don't know what it's called, but. So you come in here, and then you see this area where you're supposed to place 4 pets. Once all your pets are full grown, you could go ahead and place them. So I'm just going to do an example. This is a full grown monkey, and you could just place it right there. It's that easy, and once you place all 4, then it'll magically turn into a neon. So I just wanted to clear that up for y'all, just to make sure that y'all know how to make a neon, because probably some of you don't. So those are all my tips for today. Once I get more tips, I will tell you guys. And now let's move on to going to my house. But before I do that, I want to show you a way how you can get to your house without using Robux. So basically, you know how you can go to the shop and you could get the magic door right there. There's actually a way that you don't have to get the magic door. The way that you could do this is press the Roblox icon right there and press reset character. Now you will not have your pet once you reset, but it will still have the exact same needs. See? Right in the bottom corner. And that's just an easy way how to get to your house without using Robux. So that'll save you like 100 Robux on that door. So just do that instead of wasting your Robux. Now, a tour of my new house. So over here I have this dining table with a cute little flower on it, and it's very modern, so I love it. Then right here I have my tiny living room area with a nice TV. Over here I have my kitchen with an island, and it has a cash register thing on it. And in here is my party room with a disco ball, a nice chair, cute wallpaper, and a disco floor. So in here is my room, and I just have a dresser thing, a TV, and my sofa with a star thing on top, and a cute little shelf, and an area for your pets. Now for the upstairs area, I think it's actually my most favorite part. Over here, I have so I could do Roblox edits or stuff for my thumbnails. And over here, I have a sitting area. I'm saving this bathroom right here for last because it's the best room in the whole house. So this is the guest room. Pretty simple. It didn't cost much money, so I didn't really make it too expensive. So over here is the bathroom. It's the best room of all. It is so modern, and I love it so much. And it's just amazing, at least in my opinion, because I just love modernness. It's just amazing. Just, ah. Mwah. So, thank you so much for watching. I really hope that this helped you guys out with making your neons. If y'all have more questions about making neons, go ahead and comment that down below. And yeah, that's about all I have to say. So before I go, please like, subscribe, turn on the post notification bell, and maybe share this video with your friends if you think that they'll like it. Bye!